Providing me this opportunity and platform to talk to you about this issue, which has been drawing, you know, increasing attention of late. Though the issue is a pretty straightforward one, but still there are some, you know, confusions and some doubts, and I'll be happy to clarify if, you know, there is anything to be asked after I, you know, introduce you the issue. This issue of providing Korean nationals with visa on arrival was in the air for quite some time, and during President Park's visit, it was announced that it would be implemented, and as a follow-up to that, we had started implementing the tourist visa on arrival scheme for Korean nationals starting from April 15th this year. Now, as probably some of you would be aware that this is tourist visa, it will be of 1 month duration, single entry, can be availed twice in a calendar year, not in a year, in a calendar year. And all that you need to do is to arrive at any of the 8 designated airports. These are Delhi, Mumbai, Chennai, Kolkata, Hyderabad, Bangalore, Kochi, and Thiruvananthapuram. And proceed to the designated counters, produce your passport. The requirements are that you should have a passport, valid passport with minimum 6 months validity. You should have a return ticket, and you may or may not carry 3 photographs, because the photographing facilities are available at the airports also. But if you carry, it's better. So that's the requirement. You will be provided with a form. You will be asked to deposit the fee, which is $60 per person. So you deposit the fee, you fill up the form, you produce it at the designated counters, and you will be provided this 1 month single entry tourist visa. There have been some doubts with regard to the scope of this particular facility. I think the scope has been made pretty clear in the declaration that you find, that you sign on those particular forms. You make a declaration, I mean, there's a declaration printed on the form, then you sign it. It says that it is valid for the purpose of tourism, meet, number one, meeting friends and family. So these are the 3 broad categories. Now, I mean, what these mean is probably, you know, there's not much of scope of interpretation in here. So this is valid, valid for to cover broadly these 3 activities. And as we said earlier, the earlier speakers have said that we expect India-Korea relations to sort of to reach a higher level in days to come. And I presume that this facility that has been extended will do its bit in promoting the relations between the 2 countries. Now, I'm basically here that, you know, in case there are any doubts with regard to this, then you please ask whatever questions or whatever doubts are in your mind, and I'll be happy to clarify those. In case there are no questions, then probably I have time to just touch upon, you know, something which is related to it. Yeah.
I'll ask one question.
Sure.
You mentioned for purposes of tourism, meeting family or friends.
Yes.
What happens if you actually go and meet a business associate? Is this one of those Indian ambiguities which is meant to, you know, allow various things?
Well, probably.
I know you're speaking as an official of the government, so it's a tough one to answer.
Yeah, I mean, keeping, if you go into the spirit of the provisions that have been made, probably it may not be in the right spirit. And as you know, that the rules or the consequences of violating your visa terms in India are pretty severe. It is also that in case, I mean, the chances of which happening, you know, could be minimal owing to the fact that, you know, you can't really trace each and everybody's whereabouts for what he's doing once he enters India. But if, you know, one is caught violating the visa norms, then the consequences are, you will be put in what is called the blacklist, and getting your name removed from there can be a Herculean task. So the decision and the discretion will be totally up to the individual. So, but I don't think, you know, if you go and meet and have some minor meetings or discussions, that should be much more expensive.
So I have a question about the business visa, because I travel to India every 2 months or so to meet the team or the customers, and it's quite inconvenient to have to renew my visa every year. You can do it?
I can do it.
So is there any discussions on extending the duration of the visa from 1 year to 2 years?
Thank you for your question. I'm not really sure why you have been, I mean, you are being granted 1 year visa only. In case there is a need and there is justification, we'll surely be happy to grant you more than 1 year visa.
Okay.
Yeah, sure. In fact, under the special agreement between India and Korea, business visa up to a duration of 5 years with multiple entries can be granted, provided there is a justification. So there's no, I mean, why this restriction of 1 year has been, have you applied for 1 year only, or are there any other reason? I'll not be able to go into the specifics, but as for the provisions go, you can get up to 5 year multiple entry visa.
I've been doing this through our travel agents.
So you talk to your travel agents and tell them that the provisions are available, and if you require and there is a proper justification, we'll be happy to issue that. Not a problem at all.